This is chapter 9, Traders, Kings and Pilgrims, chapter 9. So here are the pictures. We are going to see the questions. It may be MCQ, it may come in fill in the blanks, true, false, short question answer. So we would like to cover all the chapter, and these are the pictures we are going to come back whenever it is required. The first question is, the Chinese rulers used to send gifts of silk to Iran and West Asia. Iran, West Asia. So here Iran, this is Iran, and this is Asia. So this is West Asia. So China, from China, the traders, or you can say the gift, are sent to these places. This is true. And main was silk, resham. The wearing of silk became the fashion among rulers and rich people in. So wearing silk, because silk is very slippery, very shining and smooth, and it looks different. So let me take you first to this picture. This is the silk. This is how the resham or silk looks. It's so shiny. And when this dress is taken or worn, then it looks something outstanding. So we are talking about Rome. We are talking about Rome. So this area which I am talking about, all these routes, this is Rome. This is Italy. Whenever you have Italy in mind, Rome in mind, they both are almost same. Because Rome was the Samrajya. Name the place from where silk was mostly exported. From where this is exported. So, as we answered, it's China. From China, silk was mostly exported. 7,000 years back. Let me tell you, 7,000 years back, Chinese knew. They already knew the technique how to make silk. But we came to know, that is, the world came to know, around 3000 to 2500 years back, how this silk can be created. So, you know, the thing is, because trading started around 3000 years back, so when they used to go from different place, they used to take this silk, and also the gifts were being sent. Name the ruler who controlled silk route effectively. Who was the ruler? He controlled resham marg, silk route, effectively. Who was that? He was actually that empire is called Kushanas. So I'll just take you to this picture. Here, this red which you see, this all is the land route of silk. The blue one is the sea route. So there are different routes, and these all routes are combinedly, collectively called as silk routes. It has mountains, it goes through sea, it goes to desert. That is why it's so important at that time. And this route which I am showing here, this route here, Kushanas were there. Takshashila we have Mathura. Mathura was the second capital of Kushanas. So this rasta, this pathway, this route, silk route, was controlled by Kushanas, and this port, from this port, the silk will go forward. So Kushanas will be the answer. Name the ruler used to demand payments for allowing traders to pass through the silk route. Now all these silk route, whichever you say, silk was quite expensive, and it was required also. The demand was very much. So just take a patch. Let us take that Kushanas patch again. So this patch, I'm just giving an example. So what will they say? You are going through, they'll ask the trader, okay, you are going through this path. So if you're taking 100 rupees stuff, give me 5 rupees. And we'll make sure your protection and security when you are passing through this route. So name the rulers. Again, the answer is Kushanas. From where did Phocion begin his journey back to his home, Fashyan. Now let me take you here. So there are three Chinese travelers. One is Fashyan, second one is Xuanzang, and third is Yijing. So the question is Fashyan. From where did he started his journey back home, back to his home? So he started from Bengal. This is Bengal. So from here he went back. Where is Nalanda located at present? So let me just show you. Yijing. He came to Nalanda to study. At that time it was a university. So Bihar. The answer is Bihar. Where is the site of Aran located? It's in Madhya Pradesh. The district is Sagar. Appar, a Tamil poet, was a devotee of the god Appar. So he was a poet, a Tamil poet, and he was a devotee of god Shiva. Shiv, Bhagwan Shiv. So this is Bhagwan Shiv or god Shiv, deity Shiv. He was being worshipped by Appar. Who were Nayanars. So those noble devotees graced by the Lord Shiva at that time, or they thought they were graced by the Lord Shiva or Bhagwan Shiva, deity Shiva, Sharan Meliya, were known as Nayanars. How many Nayanars were there? 63 Nayanars were there. 63. Name the community of Appar. The famous Tamil poet. So he was a great poet. So what is the community of Appar? So Appar, his Apana Appar Nayanar, also known as Nuvu Karasar, an Appar father, was a 7th century Saiva Tamil poet saint, one of the most prominent of the 63. I just discussed 63 Nayanars, and he was an older contemporary of Thirungosana Sambada. So he comes from Velelar community. In South India, there were three communities: Velelar community, Uzavar, and then Kadaisiyar or Adimai. So they belong to this first community, who were Syrian Christians. Now Christians also and Syrian also. So Syria is a Middle East country. So we are talking about Christians of Kerala. These Christians came from Syria. That is what is thought. So this area is Kerala. This area is Kerala, and very small area, very small state, but it's one of the most, you can say, developed and talked about state. 100% educated, good health facilities. So the Christians of Kerala. State the birthplace of Jesus Christ. Bethlehem. Jesus Christ born in Bethlehem. Name the port under the Cholas. So let me take you here. Cholas. So Chera, Chola, Pandya. Now what is the famous port? Kaveri Patnam, also called as Puhar. Kaveri Patnam or Puhar. So Kaveri Patnam. Name the ruler who was given the title of Lords of the Dakshinapath. If you see here, here we have, at this time Satavahan Empire was there, it was developing, and there was a famous king, and the king, he was actually called as Gautami Putra. So this Satavahana Empire, and there are questions which are coming. lord of Dakshinapat. What is this Satvahana empire? So here we have a path to Dakshin, that is south, Satkarani. So this north and south, the path, Dakshin path means path to the south, right? The path to go to the south, the lord of Dakshinapat. So let me write it here. Satvahanas is the answer. Name the most fertile river valley in southern India. Most, that is given in the question, the chapter, Kaveri Nadi, Kaveri River. So we'll write it as Kaveri. Name the most important ruler of Satvahanas. So I just told you in the previous discussion. So the important ruler of Satvahanas is Sri Satkarani. Fashian, Zhuangzang and Yijing were Chinese travelers, pilgrims basically. They came for Tirth Yatra. Fashian, he is Zhuangzang and he is Yijing. So Yijing, Fashian, Zhuangzang, and they were Chinese Tirth Yatri, pilgrims. From where the raw silk is extracted, resham, raw means it is extracted from, it's extracted from some plant or some, you know, let me just show you here. This is the shehtoot leaf, on which some insect, the silkworm, called as silkworm. So they eat these leaves and then they develop or cover them with some stuff. Okay. And like a net or a cobweb. And that is the silk. This is the raw silk. So cocoons of silkworms are, this is an insect. Now it will develop a covering outside, and that is called cocoon, and that is cocoons of silkworms. What is the meaning of the term Movendar? So Movendar is a Tamil word which means three chiefs. What does it mean? Movendar, this word we got it in Sangam Sahitya. Movendar in Sangam Sahitya is used for three chiefs. And who are these? CCP. Let us go to the picture. We are talking about Chola, Chera, Pandya. CCP. Chola, Chera, Pandya. So these are, in South India, these were the three chiefs, or you can say Movendar. These are the only Movendars. Satvahanas became powerful in Western India. True or false? Satvahanas become powerful. This is absolutely correct. Satvahanas, let me show you the area again. This is Satvahana. North, south, east, west. So, western area, they also went there. Madurai was the capital of city of Madurai. Where is Madurai? See, this is Madurai. What do you think? Is it Pandyas or Cheras or Cholas? So it's Pandyas. Okay? It's Pandyas. Madurai was the capital of Pandyas, one of the Movendars. CCP. So all these CCP, all these Samrajya or the area, they have two point of governance. Point of governance, because they are all the coastal areas. So one point of governance was on the coast. If you talk about Pandya, one of them, the inside one governance was done from Madurai. For example, if you take CCP, the Cholas or Cheras, they also have two center of governance. So that is why Madurai was the capital of Pandyas, but one more point of governance was there. Who issued gold coins for the first time? So Kushanas issued the gold coins specifically for the Silk Route, gold coin. And they started using the gold coins. What was the purpose of gold coins? Gold coins, what was the purpose? As I said, Kushanas started that. So the gold coins were used, the gold coins were given to the traders along the Silk Route. So this Silk Route, as I was saying, traders used to take this path to transfer this or to export these different stuff, mainly the silk. So this area, this. So I told you that Kushana area, gold coins. Who composed the biography of Buddha? Now this answer you have to give me. Okay, I'll wait for the answer. So thank you so much. Take care of yourself.